Time we are hearing from the parents of the man who was stabbed to death at a bus stop in Edina in what appears to be a random attack.
The family is speaking as we learn disturbing new details about the suspect who made his first appearance in court today. Lou Ragus was there. Lou, what'd you learn?
Well, Chris and Julie, the family of 62-year-old Chris Lundegaard is essentially still shocked that this happened and disappointed that earlier red flags concerning the suspect didn't lead to him getting help and an incident like this prevented.
He was fun to talk to.
The father of 62-year-old Chris Lundegaard will miss their weekly phone conversations every Sunday at 11 a.m. on the dot.
Not 10:59, not 11:01. In fact, I sometimes kid him. I say, you're 2 minutes late. And he said, no, not by my clock.
Retired Star Tribune movie critic Bob Lundegaard says he and his meticulous son, Chris, would talk films and other interests. That tradition, along with many other, gone. After Chris was violently murdered at an Edina bus stop the night before Thanksgiving.
It's a torment, basically. It's very tough.
The man charged with the crime is 32-year-old Adam Garcia, who has a long history of mostly nonviolent crimes, but one prior conviction is eerily similar. In 2019 at the U of M, a student studying in the medical library at Deal Hall was randomly stabbed by a hypodermic needle. According to the criminal complaint, police found Garcia, who then pulled out a long knife, cutting one of the arresting officers.
And I question whether not enough attention was paid at that time to make sure that he was not going to do this again.
After that incident, Garcia was temporarily civilly committed, a doctor pointing to methamphetamine-induced psychotic disorder, among other mental and chemical dependency disorders. In a judge writing, Garcia poses a substantial likelihood of causing physical harm as a result. But late last year, Garcia was discharged from probation.
I think it's a shame that he didn't apparently get any help.
Now Chris's family will follow the court case and remember the happy memories of their loved one taken so senselessly away.
He just was just a good human being.
Now, according to court documents, parts of the attack were captured on surveillance video, and police believe they found the murder weapon, a knife, nearby. Chris.
Thank you, Lou. Mm-hmm.